I'm here to make a few announcements. Firstly, we already know that at Destined for Greatness, we will Shane Torres, my man, leader of Ascription, taking on Broken Duel. But signed right here, right now, next episode of REW, we will also see Broken Duel take on Daniel Lucifer, the right-hand man of Shane Torres. Speaking of Destined for Greatness, we got some qualifier matches coming up in the next few episodes. Some Elimination Chamber qualifying matches, because we'll have 1, 2, 3 on the show. 1 for the Intercontinental Championship. 1 for the Women's Championship. And the final one will be for the vacant Kraken Championship. Speaking of that championship, we know champion Byron Pollin vacated it. And we know he's got the world championship match at WrestleMania with the Rumble winner Grim Reaper and current champion Bob Parks if he makes it there with the belt. But Giuseppe Alfred, you pissed me off. Messing with my audio, messing with Byron's audio. So the match is going to be signed for Destined for Greatness. La AIF Arcello Infamy Familia. You will defend those Trios Championships against Byron and Luxton Enterprises, baby. Aight, so check it, bruv. I'm grateful to have that Anarchy Championship match at Destined for Greatness, but me and Shamrock, we still owes you one for what you did, costing us the Midnight Tag Team titles. Come on, man. Next week, next episode, next REW, myself, Ryan Shamrock, we going spooky pervert hunting. Victor Psychosis, better watch your back. Next week, we coming for you.
Two.
listen here. Old Blake Madrick will be speaking from the heart. You see, I'm very disappointed in the way my guys lost the World Tag Team Championships to the New Age Villain Fellers. Sydal Dawn is still the REW Women's World Champion. Now that is somebody that I can be proud of. Can't say the same thing for Eduardo, Gene, and Buck. Something I have managed to be proud of is my booking abilities. Had some training with UEW, and I got Ryan to book 3 singles matches, 1 for the each of you. And we're gonna do a little trial of Blake Madrick. If you win your match tonight, you'll join Sydal Dawn as being a head coach of the Blake Madrick Boot Camp. Yeah. But if you fail, you're a dumb son of a bitch and you're going to get dishonorably discharged. This is your opportunity to make up for any mistakes you've had in the previous.
Hey, I've got very important business to be taken care of right now, but I decided to stop and take care of some business. Firstly, we finally worked out that work visa with Arcello, so he will be on REW screens again shortly. But firstly, we need to talk about some insider information we got, you know. Last episode of REW, there was some mic issues with both Byron Pollan and Jinku Getgoga, or Jinku Ventura, Jinku whatever, I don't know what he goes by these days, but Jinku. Jinku, my friend, I'm very sorry for that. That was meant purely for Byron Pollan, not you. You see, an insider told me that Byron Pollan was going to challenge La AIF, my family, for the Trios Championships, and when you mess with my family, you get messed with back. So I refused to give him a proper microphone. I had my people on the inside screw with him. Because you do not deserve a chance to challenge for our trio. Put in the work making this Trios division the greatest on the planet like we have. But whatever. Jinku, yet again, my bad. Hopefully, no hard feelings. But there's one more man, one more beast, one more boar that I need to address. Sator assaulting us. That is disgusting. And will have hell to pay, not at the hands of myself, but at the hands of my family, who yet again do not take kindly to that sort of disrespect. Byron, Sator, we'll be seeing you in the near future. Let's go, Arcello.
Ah!